I just got myself into an older Ford Escape, and this one was a first. I'm not quite sure exactly how it happened. But the doors were all locked. This one's got a backup camera, but an itty-bitty screen way off in the distance in the middle of the dash, like on top of the dash, recessed. I don't know who came up with the design of this dashboard, but it is terrible. Not sure what year it is. It's a lot different than the current Escapes. It's old enough to have a CD slot. Yeah, itty bitty screen. I'm pretty sure it's not a touchscreen. If it is, it's useless as a touchscreen because it's well out of arm's reach. My headlights are not on. I got the auto lights on now. Some tunes going. All right, I'm getting a volume knob. Volume though. Connect a Bluetooth device. Yeah, I'm not messing with Bluetooth devices. I just want to listen to the radio. All right, there's a button that says radio. No, I'm not listening to Camel Country. Oh, this is kind of neat. When I turn the knob, it's got a tuning knob. Not only does it show digital and larger text so I can see what frequency it's on, it gives a graphic image of an analog radio dial. I like that. Of course, it would be a lot better if that screen wasn't at such a far distance and small. That's far enough away I can barely read what it says. It says 7:26 p.m. That's probably correct. So I pulled this out of the dollar maintenance line. Damn, I forgot where it's going already. I guess I'll sort that out when I get to the gatekeeper line. I had a chat with one of the car washers that I say hi to every now and then down at Dollar about what was going on with me moving the windshield chips. That's my last one until any more come in. Like, I saw four, maybe five cars over in the Hertz maintenance line. It's been a long time since I've gone over the Hertz maintenance line. And I left two more over in the Dollar line, actually right when I was getting into this vehicle, which, by the way, I got into by reaching through the passenger window. The passenger window was maybe about 20% rolled down. When I've got thin enough arms, I was able to reach through it and hit the electric locks to let myself in. And then the keys are hanging right in the ignition. I don't know how the hell they do that. Probably an automated feature. Oh, this one is PM stop. This is such a fun song. Two steps, two steps, one. It comes to two, to three, to the four. Everybody drunk out on the dance floor. Baby girl, dance, she go like she want more. Like she a groupie and I ain't even no tour. Maybe cause she heard that I rhyme hardcore. Oh, they're pulling a lot of PMs in right now. They're otherwise getting them kicked out. We're going to take this one right to the front. Pretty sure I got all those Volvos out. At this point, I'm close enough to car wash. I'm just going to walk across and get a clean to take up. Actually, I forgot I got this Ford Edge here. It's a vertical screen Ford. These screens are so big and obnoxious. Forgot I had this jammed right up against the light pole. Need to go to the ridge wall. Okay, why are the lights still on? Are they turned on? No. Okay, there we go. All better. It was so weird, they weren't on when I got in the car, but then they just kind of came on and stayed on. Okay, I got the lights on auto. This one's going to the registration wall. I already saw the tag on it.
You've got to awkwardly back up towards the car wash because instead of putting it in one of the lines on either side of the pole, they put it right up against the pole. Yeah, our car washers, for the most part, are kind of a special bunch. I am so hungry. 7:32 right now. All right, I got somebody rolling through in front of me with headlights on and no taillights. Most likely daytime running lights. Got two vehicles and the gatekeeper at the back end of it. At least taking this to the reg while I can get over there and make sure that I don't have any more electrics to move. I think that Mercedes was my last one. Oh yeah, that was it. As I was saying, our car washers are a special bunch. Most of them. And this Ford Expedition that I'm in is a perfect example of that. So, no note on the window, no paper tag indicating the problem, but it's here in the gatekeeper line. And my job is to try to figure out what the deal is with it. Well, as soon as I sat down, the deal was pretty obvious. The left windshield wiper is missing. And the wipers are kind of up a little ways. I didn't think too much of that, and perhaps I should have. But, well, yeah, I noticed the wiper's up a little bit, and the left one missing. I'm thinking, well, that's simple. Paint cat, wipers. Get it moved. I start the vehicle, and then immediately, the wipers start going. It's missing the left wiper blade. So I've got the metal of the wiper blade arm scraping against the windshield fast, like it's on its highest setting. And I hate how there's no standardization of how those types of controls are in motor vehicles. So I'm reaching around the right side, because on most vehicles, granted not all, very much not this, that's where you find the wiper controls. Nope. It took me a while to find them. They're on the turn signal stock on the left side. But I got them turned off. Hopefully it doesn't look like it's scratched the windshield, but it certainly easily could have. Like, why would you stop a car with the windshield wipers on the highest setting? And the rear windshield wiper was on its highest setting as well, too. That was also on the turn signal stalk, but it was a little harder to figure out how to turn that off. Which reminds me, the very first day that I worked here, first had us do some up-downs, and the very first vehicle, clean vehicle I got in as an employee of MLS, I drove up. And it was driving me nuts how, as I was driving it up the ramp, while it was hot as hell out and completely dry, the rear windshield wiper was flipping back and forth, and I could see it in the rearview mirror. I just don't understand why they don't train the car washers to turn that shit off when they park the car, whether they park it in the clean area or the gatekeeper. It doesn't seem to have damaged the windshield. I don't know. I kind of see a little bit of a scratch. Hopefully it just washes off. But it'd be pretty sad if, just due to that kind of negligence, they have to replace this thing's stupid windshield. All right, I'm finally taking another cleanup. I haven't done this in a while. Oh, no. 99.9 has switched to their Christmas format. Ugh, I hate that shit. Yuck. No Christmas music before, no Christmas music before Thanksgiving. This is a Kia Carnival. I don't see these very often. This seems to be Kia's entry into the giant killing machine SUV class of vehicles. Although it's doesn't seem to be any bigger than a Ford Explorer. I'm just glad it's got the HD radio and I can go right to AWSS HD. I really dig the psychedelic furs. Got to see them in the late 90s. That was a great show. Mid 90s, somewhere in there. It was after Love Spit Love. And Love Spit Love had broken up, and psychedelic furs were back together and touring. So I had to go to that. Those things got 60,000 miles on it, so I'm just gonna stick it in the flip ramp. Which I expect to be a little chaotic because I've noticed that the car washers are doing up downs. Oh, dang it, I hit the wrong button. Speaking of car washers, I think I finally figured out who it is that's using the black marker on the windows that are completely illegible.